quarterbacks. Joel Klatt put out his mock draft at FoxSports.com. He has Sam Darnold going number one to the Browns, Baker Mayfield going at number five to the Broncos, and UCLA's Josh Rosen going sixth overall to the Jets. Danny, which quarterback do you think will be the best in the NFL?
All right, so I don't love any of these quarterbacks, right? We talked about that with Lamar Jackson. That's why I kind of like him at a lower spot. I think more so than ever in the last probably decade, where a quarterback gets selected is going to matter more than most years. Absolutely. And it's that case for every quarterback, but even more so with this group. I feel like they all have little red flags or little issues that they need help around them. So if I'm looking at Joel Klatt's mock draft right there, I'm loving Baker Mayfield to Denver at five. Like, I think that is a home run. But I also love Baker Mayfield as compared to this class. I think we're doing the same thing we did last year with Deshaun Watson when we saw Mitch Trubisky and Patrick Mahomes selected before Deshaun Watson. I think we're looking at him. We're trying to say, well, is he a product of the system? It's just stats. He's just putting up obnoxious stats. But, how is it going to be in the NFL? This guy is a winner. He's won at every phase of his game, high school, college, and I think that carries over. I love the chip on the shoulder. I love his decision making on the field. He does not turn the ball over. Again, you put him in the right system, he is going to flourish in the NFL. Top tier arm talent, pinpoint accuracy. He's got the most important skill set.
And sometimes I think the quarterback wins stat can be overrated, but why did Oklahoma win those games? Because Baker Mayfield was the best player on the field, very similar to Clemson. Now, Clemson had great defense, they had great skill position players, but they had the best player on the field in Deshaun Watson. So it's one thing to be part of a winning culture, to be part of a winning program. It's another thing to be the predominant reason your team is winning high leverage, big playoff-type games, championship-type games, as Deshaun Watson was, as Baker Mayfield was.
I think the Andrew Luck, the conversation at this point, Andrew Luck's career, it validates the point that you make as far as right now, it's more important to be with a team that supports you and the supporting cast from an organization standpoint, from a talent standpoint, from a resources they're going to commit to running game and offensive line in front of you. The reason why we've seen some of our recent quarterbacks, the Rams, Jared Goff, their investment in that offensive line, getting Whitworth, getting Todd Gurley squared away. The reason why they were successful. Let's look at Carson Wentz in Philadelphia. Dominant offensive line, dominant left tackle, dominant right tackle, three running backs. So you are right. When you're looking at these guys, you better start, before you can answer the question, who's going to be the most successful, we need to determine where they're going to go and what type of support. The Denver Broncos, for 40 years, have supported their team. They've been a great organization. Like, they are one of the marquee franchises. So Baker going there, that would be a great get for them, and it would be better for his career.
Do you want the Danny Cannell mock draft?
Yes.
Because I got the plan.
I was about to ask.
I'm going to fix Cleveland's problems, okay?
Hold on.
I'm fixing their quarterback problems.
Don't do it, Danny.
I'm taking Saquon Barkley at one. All those quarterbacks you mentioned with the good offensive lines around them, what else do they have? Dynamic running game. You left out another one. Dak Prescott with Ezekiel Elliott, dynamic, and their offense was close to unstoppable. Saquon Barkley at one. If you can trade down a little bit and still get Baker Mayfield, I would take him. But I would not shy away from taking Baker Mayfield at four. Put Saquon Barkley and Baker Mayfield in your backfield and tailor make your offense with those two guys back there and say, good luck stopping us.
See, I want Cleveland to draft a quarterback at one and a quarterback at four so they can actually get the thing right.
I wouldn't be opposed to that.
And by the way, people say it's crazy. We see teams every year trade multiple first-round picks to go get a quarterback. But we don't have to get into that right now. Here's the thing I want to ask you, though.
They did with RG3 and Kirk Cousins. Same thing. Take quarterback.
So let's talk about the California quarterbacks for a moment. Chris is more partial to Sam Darnold. I'm more partial to Josh Rosen. Both of these guys have played in warm weather their entire careers, whether it was
Danny
high school
Cannell,
or college.
Fort Lauderdale. All right.
And we saw evidence.
Yeah, went to the academy, went to Florida State. How did that win?
Exactly. Not very good.
Well, so two things. One is, talk to us about how real it is going from playing in nice weather, perfect circumstances, to whether it's Cleveland or New York with the Jets or New York with the Giants, a lot of these, Denver even. that, and of those two California quarterbacks, Rosen and Darnold, who do you think is the better NFL player?
So as far as going from warm weather to cold weather, I think it's individual. Some guys will be able to respond to it. Now you can actually throw with gloves on. I mean, the benches are heated nowadays. And as far as any college program that you play, you're going to be done by Thanksgiving for the most part. And then you're going to play in a warm weather, you know, bowl game. So you're not getting that much of a test. Even if you're at Michigan or Ohio State, it's still not that cold.
Yeah, two or three games.
Right. And you're in the NFL, you're putting your back half of your season is going to be much colder. So I think that's overblown a little bit. But you definitely want to try to figure that out. That's why I think hand size comes into play. And as much as I hate the underwear Olympics that we call the combine, some of the stuff does matter. You want guys to have a certain hand size so they can grip the ball in cold weather. For these two quarterbacks, again, not in love with either one of them for different reasons. With Sam Darnold, I think you've seen inconsistency. I didn't love the way he handled, and it was a ton of pressure and stress on him, but I thought it impacted his play. If on the field at USC this year, especially early in the season, if you take him at number one for the Cleveland Browns, there will be more stress and pressure than anything compared to what he had in this past offseason coming into his last season at USC. With Josh Rosen, I know you like him. He scares me because of the intangibles off the field stuff. I love when I watch him on film. I love what I see from him from a quarterback standpoint, pure pocket passer, really natural arm talent, arm motion. But I'm scared of what he does in a locker room, handling media, being outspoken politically. That scares me from what you want your franchise quarterback to be.
And I love it. That's probably, right. To be totally honest, it's probably one of the reasons I like him as much as
sure.
I do. So, I mean, that's just different taste.
I almost feel like he falls in the line of Jeff George, Jay Cutler, Josh Rosen. Incredibly talented, but is he a guy that has the players gravitate toward him and want to go to battle with him and will win games for him and all these types of things that make great NFL quarterbacks great? I don't know if Josh Rosen has those assets.
Right. One of the next important things, let me see your hand. Let me see this hand right here.
Yeah.
All right. You see that?
Oh, man.
Okay. Now, you see that? If those kids, you see that's that at the combine. Now, see that?
Yeah.
All right.
Maybe
now,
that's why I couldn't throw at the metal.
All right. Now, if I'm the Cleveland Browns and one of the kids have a hand like Chris Carter, that's about 10 and 3 quarters from the pinky.
Because you have a big hand.
Engulfed.
Okay. Like, that right there makes a difference, and that's the difference between Troy Aikman, Brett Favre, and some of these other guys. Their hand size. That will determine, too, if they can throw the ball in the cold.
Can I ask one question about Rosen? You guys tell me if it's unfair. Is it unfair that when I look at him and I say, you're a 22-year-old, peak of your athleticism college athlete, that he doesn't look like he is in the most amazing shape I've ever seen? That he has a little of the Ben Roethlisberger face, and Roethlisberger at a 35-year-old NFL quarterback established, that's one thing. I look at Baker Mayfield. The guy looks like he's cut out of granite. Josh Rosen's a thin guy. He's not super muscular, but is that unfair?
Well, what I think is not unfair is, does that influence his ability to stay healthy? Because he has struggled with injuries.
Right.
Whether it was concussions or other issues, whether he had shoulder issues, you know, other more hand issue this past season, that would concern me, because part of the evaluation process, when you're looking at all these guys, is can they survive 16 games in the NFL? And it's not an easy question to answer.
Right. And can he do like Jared Goff did? All right, got banged around his first year, but second year, he started understanding the game. He's bing, bing, bing. He's letting the ball go, and he's a pure passer of the football. You can become that, but you have to understand that you're not going to make a living by holding on to the football and taking on these people by your physical presence. You're going to have to be able to get rid of the football, but he does have to get bigger, because the wear and tear, eventually it wins out in the NFL.
Would you take him in New York City?
Who's the him?
Josh Rosen.
Absolutely.
So
absolutely. I think he's, listen, you guys, and young guys like the outspoken, politically active, thoughtful guy. Like, I think guys are more apt to follow that than they were in the past. I think the younger generation of players is less determined that you have to just be football, football, football. And you said Jeff George, Jay Cutler. I'm not sure Jay Cutler knows who the president is, much less I have a lot of opinions.
I meant from a leadership in the locker room, not politically,
yeah.
You know, outside.
No, No, of course.
Yeah, I just meant from a locker room perspective. Yeah.
We'll hear Danny's political thoughts.
Another day.
Let me see the right hand. Let me see the right hand.
No, it's the same.
Okay, my left one is bigger.
Is he cheating? Hold on.
Okay,
Danny,
okay.
Thank you for being here.
Man.
Coming up, are the Warriors in trouble out west? That's next on First Things First.
Combine, the hand test. I'm telling you.
Those one-handed grabs.
Unbelievable. Yeah.